Ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Gaming community, it is time to do the notification bay slash bro of the day before we get into today's video. Also, I want to say thank you very much because this Duels Pack Dimensional Guardian set review is very well received, even though it only has 33 views right now. That should go up over the next week or two. But the comments wise, there's a good number of comments, so I'm very happy with that. But without any further ado, let's go ahead and get into these shout outs real quick before we jump into today's video. Shout out goes to John Dolan. He is going to be the notification bro of the day. He was reporting for duty, smashing that like button. Thank you so much, John Dolan. I always appreciate it, brother. We also got my buddy T Gundam Samurai, aka Dice Boy 22. Go check out his channel. Give him a subscribe. Tell him that Avery sent you. Same thing for John Dolan. We also got Team Scrub Life Gaming, my homie. That's a beautiful picture. I can't really tell what it is from this distance, but it's a nice picture. He commented, he left a like. Let's go ahead and go show him some love. We also got Amy McLean, author and film blogger with 11,000 subscribers. Now that is insane. I'll be honest, I don't make a habit of buying nipple tassels on the weekend, but here is your comment. 11,000 subscribers, damn. I did not think I would get someone with 11,000 subscribers commenting on my channel, although granted I didn't think Capital G would be on my channel either, but let's go ahead and give her a shout out anyway. Go check out her channel. She seems like a really amazing person. We also got Joshua James down here at the bottom. Can't forget you, brother. Thank you so much for leaving a comment and being part of the notification people. And notification bays of the day, of course, go to all of you, except for John Dolan. He's going to be the notification bro. Team Gundam Samurai is going to be the notification bro. Team Scrub Life Gaming is going to be the notification bay. And Amy McLean and Joshua James are going to be the notification bays. So without any further ado, let's get into the video. What's up, you guys? Avery here. I really need to make those notification bay things shorter so that you guys aren't just watching a minute of me giving people shout outs. But if you guys do like that, then be sure to leave a like. I'm giving you guys something that actually a lot of you have requested, and I wanted to do in this video, kind of give it a try and see what you guys think. You guys wanted me to do some card reviews, and I figured I would do that for this. I know I'm 2 days late on this because the organization posted this on June 2nd. Today's June 4th, but I figured better late than never. I hadn't checked the organization in a while, so I'm kind of behind, but I figured I would talk about this. This is a new card coming out from Cyber, which is Circuit Breaker. It is called Conjoined Bird Renrin. It is, I believe it's the first ever Dragon Union monster. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure it's the first ever Dragon Union monster. It's level 3, Dark Dragon Union, 1500 attack, 0 defense. And it's not all that good. I'm going to go ahead and read you the effects. So once per turn, you can activate one of these effects. You target one face-up monster you control. Equip this card to that target, or you can unequip it and special summon it. That's standard for all Union monsters. You can equip it to a monster or unequip it in order to special summon it. Now, if a monster equipped with this card would be destroyed by battle or card effect, you get to destroy that instead. So it kind of has a Machina gear frame effect plugged into it, which is nice. The original attack of a monster equipped with this card becomes 1,000. Also, it can make a second attack during each battle phase. And a little interesting note here that I saw while reading this. This thing is a reference to a legendary Chinese creature called the Bianio. I'm probably butchering that, but a species of bird that was said to be born with only one wing. So the males and females have to stay together in order to fly. Over the years, the term "baiwai" has been used to describe lovers who are very close. And I love that my voice is so deep because I just got back from a party the other night and my voice is practically gone, so I want to make this video nice and quick, short, sweet, and to the point. But to describe this effect in one word, sucks. It's kind of a shame too, because Union monsters, majority of them anyway in this game, have a reputation of not being all that good, except for, like, you know, the Machinas, like gear frame and all that, just because that they synergize very well with the deck. And you know, of course, besides the ABCs, they're like the only good ones. Besides Machina and ABCs, there's no really any other good Union monsters in the game. And the fact that, you know, it does what every other Union does. You target a face-up monster, equip it or unequip a special summon it, and then it has the effect to protect the monster. Okay, sure, that's cute. And then it decreases the monster's attack down to 1,000, and then it can make a second attack during each battle phase. But it's like, even though you're making a second attack during each battle phase, what the hell are you going to kill with a 1,000 beater? So maybe this combos with something else in Circuit Breakers that I haven't seen. I don't know. The only way I could really see this being effective is in a dragon deck where you're playing unions? Sure, I guess. I don't know. Maybe in Red Eyes. And then you can pump it up with, like, Red Eyes Black Dragon Sword and make it a big ass beater, so its original attack becomes 1,000, but then once you bulk it up, then it just gets bigger, and then it can make a second attack during each battle phase. But it's like, Red Eyes already has big beaters. Why would you ever decrease its attack down to 1,000 when they pretty much trample over everything that they battle in? Plus, they do a lot of burn damage, so you'd be better off just focusing on a burn based Red Eyes deck. But let me know what you guys think in the comments below. This card just seems pretty much ass. Like, I think it's gonna probably be like a common in Circuit Breakers, but I figured I would cover it anyway. Just see what kind of reception I get on a video like this, because I know that you guys requested it and I wanted to deliver. But really, just the effect's very bland. It makes the monster's attack become 1,000, so it's really not all that good. You know, if it made it something like its original attack becomes 2,000 or 3,000, then yeah, I could definitely see that being good. But just making its original attack 1,000 and making it attack twice, like, seems kind of like an oxymoron. Like, what are you gonna run over with 1,000 attack? But anyway, I'm gonna go and rest my voice now. I'm probably gonna go back to bed because I'm just so tired. I didn't go to bed till like a little bit after 2 o'clock in the morning. So thank you guys for watching. As always, be sure to leave a comment, hit smash that like button, and if you want to be part of the notification squad, all you gotta do is hit that ding dong notification bell, and then you too may be able to be the notification bae or bro of the day. Probably notification bae because, you know, I'm single and I need me a bae. But anyway, thank you guys for watching as always, and subscribe if you've not already.